a lot. Everything, because God is, he has everything to do with it. Because for those of you out there who are Christians, and for those of you who aren't, I'm going to just tell you a story about Abraham and Sarah. And basically, this is just a couple in the Bible who were extremely old. They had trouble conceiving. They always wanted a child, but at the end of it, they were super old. I mean, they had been like, they're, let's just say, really old. And what happened was an angel came from heaven and told, it was either Abraham or Sarah that they were having a child. And no, it was Abraham. Sarah was listening, and Sarah laughed. And when Sarah laughed, that was essentially her saying, I don't believe what God is saying. And at the end of it, you know, I believe what happened after that was the angel had rebuked her and had closed her mouth for the 9 months that they were supposed to have that child or something like that.
Not necessarily. What he did was he rebuked her and right. let her know that you will have a child, right. whether or not you believe it.
You know,
and she did end up conceiving within a year.
Within a year.
We actually just talked about this in the last video where we talked about finding your joy, so make sure y'all check that out as well.
You guys can find that right here. It'll pop up in a little icon.
Oh, cool.
Anyway, so essentially the details of the story are vague to me. I've read it several times, but essentially at the end of the day, when it comes to the life of a child, when it comes to the death of a child, David and Bathsheba, you guys know that they both had a child, not only out of wedlock, but out of the event that her husband died, and essentially David killed her, killed him. And at the end of the day, the life of that child was put at risk because of what David did. So, boom, that child died. You had Moses and Pharaoh. They were going at it because Moses wanted the Israelites to be free. Pharaoh didn't want to do it. God killed the firstborn son of every person in that country, including Pharaoh. So that's when Pharaoh decided to let him go. So what I'm saying is there's so many different parts of the Bible that explain, you know, the life and death of a child and what God has to do with it, that there's that question that you asked, literally the answer is, everything. Life, death, shoot, we can go Hannah and her going to the church, praying for the child, you know, waiting for that time. She finally got the child, the life of that child, you know, everything. So, everything.
Yeah. Okay, great. So, the next question that we have is, have you struggled at all with your faith during this process of trying to conceive? And if so, how did you get back on track?